sitting on the shoulder of the constellation of Orion with a distinctly reddish hue. Betelgeuse is one of the more recognizable stars in the night sky, but it is also one of the fastest changing. While Ptolemy described it orange-tawny, Chinese observers 3 centuries earlier say it was yellow. Hence, astronomers call it a variable star because it pulsates, expanding and contracting in size over time. This pulsation causes the star's brightness to fluctuate, sometimes making it one of the brightest stars in the sky and at other times dimming significantly. That meant Betelgeuse is due to explode as a supernova sometime in the next few 100,000 or 1 million years. But soon things started happening very quickly. Now Betelgeuse is a true giant, with a diameter more than 1,000 times that of our Sun. If Betelgeuse explodes, it'll be so bright that you'd see it during the day for a whole year. If you placed it at the center of our solar system, it would engulf the inner planets, including Earth, and go all the way up to Jupiter. Its immense size and mass make it a red supergiant star nearing the end of its life. Yes, the behemoth of a star is dying, but that is not the reason for sparking our curiosity, because stars die all the time. Now Betelgeuse has begun to behave oddly again, brightening by 140% in the last month or so. Yes, Betelgeuse has started acting very strange, and looking ahead it seems like it is well set to be the next galactic supernova. And the question on everyone's lips is whether Betelgeuse is about to explode much sooner than we thought. Nobody knows for sure, except for a team of scientists.
Orbit beyone the blue.
In late 2019 and early 2020, the star underwent an unprecedented dimming event, losing a significant portion of its brightness. This sparked speculation and curiosity among scientists worldwide. Several theories emerged to explain Betelgeuse's dimming, but one possibility stood out and was later found to be correct by the Hubble Space Telescope. Analyzing data from NASA's Hubble Space Telescope and several other observatories, astronomers had concluded that Betelgeuse quite literally blew its stop in 2019, losing a substantial part of its visible surface. What we know is that as the star recovered from blasting out a huge amount of its innards, its surface is now bouncing like gelatin on a plate, and it has lost the natural 400-day heartbeat that has been present for at least 2 centuries. This is something never before seen in a normal star's behavior. And according to them, the explosion may be happening right now as you watch this, or very near in the future. Astronomers have long known that Betelgeuse is a supergiant red star at the end of this sequence and that a supernova is likely coming. The bright red supergiant star that marks Orion's shoulder is nearing the end of its life, and it's less than 1,000 light-years from Earth. But how close is it to going supernova? And will we be around to see it? Typically, astronomers suggest it might explode within the next 100,000 years, that is, soon on a cosmic time frame, not a human one. However, the only way for Betelgeuse to pulsate in this way is if it is at the very end of its carbon-burning period, which means that our calculations may be way off. A new study by Hideyuki Seo and his colleagues of the Tohoku University in Japan claim that the star might be further along in its evolution, and that it is much closer to exploding than we thought. But how are they claiming this? It's the star's pulsations. You see, Betelgeuse is unstable, breathing in and out regularly, with overlapping overtones. Following its brightness over the past century, astronomers have noted changes over periods of 2,200 days, 420 days, 230 days and 185 days. Usually, astronomers treat the 420-day up-on-down as the primary in and out pulsation, with the shorter cycles as overtones. The 2,200-day or 6-year period isn't generally considered part of these ins and outs, and is instead dubbed a long secondary period, a feature of unknown origin common to one-third of supergiant stars. If the 420-day period is the primary one, then Betelgeuse would have the span of 800 to 900 suns lined up in a row. If the 2,200-day cycle is the primary one, and all the rest are overtones, then the star would be even more supergiant, spanning 1,200 suns, even wider than Jupiter's orbit. In line with its larger size, the star would be even further along in its life cycle. Stars like Betelgeuse live fast and large. Like the Sun, they first light up by fusing hydrogen into helium within their cores, but they quickly move on to helium, fusing it into carbon. Carbon then burns to make other, heavier elements. Around the core, lighter elements burn in shells, causing the star to billow outward like a hot plasma balloon. Sayo and his colleagues use computer simulations to watch stars evolve from birth to old age. Then they calculate the pulsations they ought to see at each stage. They find that all 4 pulsations, from the 2,200-day cycle through the 185-day cycle, can be explained by a breathing star in the late stages of carbon burning. The only way for Betelgeuse to pulsate in this way is if it is at the very end of its carbon burning period. During the helium fusion stage that follows, carbon builds up in their cores. Then they begin a core carbon burning period that produces other elements. The new research says that Betelgeuse is in the late stages of that period. It's not possible to exactly estimate how much carbon is left in the core at present, Sayo says. We just guess the time to carbon exhaustion is probably less than a few hundred years. So, to put some headlines in perspective, Sayo's group isn't saying Betelgeuse will blow tomorrow or even in the next decade. The researchers' claim is that Betelgeuse would blow within 1,000 years rather than 10,000 or 100,000. The 2,200-day pulsation, if radial, creates other problems, too. Spectroscopic measurements show that the star's surface expands and contracts at some 1.5 kilometers per second, 3,300 miles per hour. If the star is breathing at this rate over the span of 2,200 days, its total diameter would be changing by 180 times the sun's size every cycle. Even for astronomers, that's a lot. What's more, the 2,200-day pulsation would also affect the pulsation of the overtones. So, for example, the 400-day cycle wouldn't always be 400 days. When the star puffs out to its full size, this overtone would lengthen. Likewise, when the star shrinks, it would shorten. These changes would be expected to repeat systematically every 2,200-day cycle, McLeod says, and I don't think we see evidence for that in Betelgeuse's long-term light curve, which varies more randomly around the 400-day typical cycle. Now for those unaware, when a star runs out of hydrogen, then helium starts to burn into carbon, which causes swelling in a star. As all the fuel is burned out, and the remaining elements do not form fuel, against their own weight, the core collapses to form a solid neutron star, which the inrush of surrounding gas rebounds against to form a supernova. If it does blow, Betelgeuse will become the brightest star in the night sky and one of the most fascinating and spectacular phenomena in human history. However, astronomers believe it is far enough away not to threaten life on Earth. But will we be able to watch the Betelgeuse explosion? If we could live for another couple of thousand years, then sure. Our near future generations will definitely get to witness this galactic event in all its glory. But what do I know?
Beyond the blue.